All right.
Oh, one more.
Mr. Speaker, according to the UN, the Chignecto Isthmus, the land connecting New Brunswick and Nova Scotia, is one of the most vulnerable to climate change in North America. The dikes that keep the Bay of Fundy out of the Sackville area are one major storm away from disastrous flooding that would put us underwater and cut off Nova Scotia from the rest of the country. The governments of New Brunswick and Nova Scotia, along with the federal government, commissioned a study in 2019 to recommend how to prevent the Bay of Fundy from flooding the Chignecto Isthmus. It was supposed to be released this past February, but 9 months later, it is yet to see the light of day. People have been waiting years for action. There's no more time to waste. The report must be tabled in the House as soon as possible. Can the Minister of Transportation and Infrastructure tell us when this important study will be made public?
The Minister of Transportation and Infrastructure.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. To the member opposite, this is a very important study. This is something that was undertaken in partnership with the federal government, the province of New Brunswick, and Nova Scotia. New Brunswick took the lead on the project. The study has been conducted over a number of months. They've looked at many different ways to protect this very important piece of land between Nova Scotia and New Brunswick. This 19 kilometers of highway and railway has transportation of commercial goods more than $50 million a day across this. It's an incredibly important connection. It's a strategic transportation corridor for Canada. We do have the draft report now. We are briefing Nova Scotia and the federal government early in December. Once that's complete, we will release the report.
The member from Etobicoke-Cantimore.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Unfortunately, things have moved slowly, and that's the level of urgency that we have come to expect from this government, Mr. Speaker. And in March, when I asked the Climate Change Committee that doesn't talk about climate change to review the government's climate action plan before the mandatory deadline of the end of this year, the Environment Minister said that they would worry about it later. Well, now it's almost December, and we still have not heard anything about the government's plan to update it. As I said in March, this is a life or death issue, Mr. Speaker. People are being displaced because of the effects of climate change, and people are dying. Nearly 500 people died in BC this summer due to extreme temperatures. People have died due to flooding and mudslides in BC this past week. Newfoundland and Nova Scotia have been hit hard this week by storms. I think that we can do more than kick the climate change can down the road. What is the Environment and Climate Change Minister's plan to update the Climate Action Plan by the end of this year, as is required by law?
The Minister of Environment and Climate Change in the gallery.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, for the important question for the member next door. It is important to us for sure. I'm not sure how many times I mentioned this already. The present plan, which is due in December, will be coming soon in the new year, very soon. The renewal plan is coming shortly after. Stakeholders will be engaged, as well as our Climate Change Stewardship Committee, to have input on that. Looking forward to under the COP26 reducing. We have 118 items right now, as you know, Mr. Speaker, and we need to bring that down into a more manageable number. Have specific targets, specific times to make sure we get finished and move ahead for climate change. They're all very important. I mentioned some yesterday as well regarding the erosion concerns of the coastline. You mentioned the Tanchamar marshes right now as well. There's lots on the go, lots to work at, and lots to plan for. But things are happening along that way. The EV program this past summer, by the way, is up and running in July. Should have a round of applause for that program with the. To join the federal money to make it happen to get more vehicles.
Time, Minister. On the road.